Hello everyone, today we are going to learn basic AutoCAD 2024, how to create 2D floor plan. Okay, here I will use units in millimeter, so you can click new and then click browse template. We use ACAD ISO template. For the first, I will create line start from this point to drag. I will set into 5000, move to the top, 8000, and then you can press enter. You can pan again this drawing. You create line start from this point to the left, 5000, and connect at this point. Use a copy command to copy this line to the top, 1000, and then 6000. We copy again about 3500, and the next 5000. Okay. Use line command to create line start from middle point to the top. And then I will copy this line object to the left, 1500. Now you can use a trim command, then cut this line. Okay, also at this point, and then in here, the next this line object. So we create this simple sketch. And then I will use break command to break this line object. You can tap break, click this line, tap F to use first point. I will click in here and then click again at this point. So it will be automatically break into two line object. Now we can use offset command. You can tap offset. We set for offset distance 150, and I will select this line offset inside. Okay, you can click it, click inside. And the next we offset with offset distance 75 in this line object, top and bottom or left and right like this. That again at this point, then in here the next this line object, and last this line. Okay, to connect between these two line object, we can use fillet command. You can tap fillet, press shift button, and select these two line. So it will be automatically connect. Okay, fillet again at this two line object. Now you can use trim. I will extend with trim command this line. Also in here. Okay, the next in the bottom here. Then in here you can click and then cut this line. Pop into here, click extend, and then in this line object, the top, it's okay. Now we can create new layer. You can tap layer, press enter. I will create two layer. For the first, we set layer into center. Set the color, we set into this color, and the second set layer into wall, and for the color I will set into yellow, then close. And now we can tap properties to show the properties tab. Now for the center, you can select this center line and apply center layer into the selected object. Okay, you can click in here and then change into center. You also can hide clicking at this drop down menu and then click this icon to hide the center layer. And this is we can create for wall layer. You can select all and then change into wall. Okay, now for door, we can create simple block. You can create line. I will create start from this point. To drag, we set into 7000, then I will create line in it to the bottom 150, to the left 50, over to the top 150, and then connect into this point. You can copy this object from this point in here. Next, I will rotate this line object from this center point. Rotation 25 degree. Enter. Use arch command to create arch start from center point. Click in it. You can click start from this point, move to the top. The next, you can offset with offset distance 20. Select this object. Click in the bottom. You can use trim command to extend this line object. So we create this simple dot. For the window, you can create a rectangle. And I will set for size into 1000, for width 150. Now we can create line start from this point into here, and then you can mirror from middle point to the top. Create this for simple window. You also can create line again from this point into here. Okay. Now in here we can convert into block. You can tap block, select the names. I will set into door. Then for click point, click in it. For object, select this all objects. Then click OK. So we create this for block reference. And the second, create again with the name window. Click point, click after this middle point. And for object, select this object. Click OK. Next, we can move. Like I will move this window from this point, okay, into middle point. Then copy, then this object to here, and then you can rotate 90 degree. Move from this point into here. So this is for window, and then for door you can copy the door object, click from this point, copy to here, and then I will use mirror command to mirror this object from middle point to the right. Okay, the next can mirror object to the top, then you can move from this point to here. The next, I will mirror this object to the left, and then you can move from this point to this point. The next, you can copy for window to here. Okay, that's it. Now to cut this line object, we can use trim command. You can tap TR and select this line to cut. Cut again at this point. The next in here. Then this line object. Okay. You can rotate this object, and then we can move from this point into here. Trim command to cut this line object. Okay, now we already insert for door and window. It's just for example. And then I will apply for hatch. You can tap hatch. I will use solid. And then we can set color into yellow. So I will select in it and click at each region one by one. The next at this point. If you want to undo, you can press Ctrl Z to undo the previous text or jobs. I will select again that is region. The last in here. Okay, if you done, you can click close hatch creation. The next, we can tap hatch again and I will use ANSI 31. You can change color into this color, and you can select like at this point. For scale, you can set 20. Click again into another region like this. You can select one by one the region. Okay, you can zoom in and zoom out by using scroll mouse to make more easy for you to select the region. The next at this point, and the last in this wall object. Click close hatch creation. Okay, now I will insert for text. We can use mtext command. You can tap mtext, press enter. I will create in here for text, and you can set the name like into kitchen. Click outside to apply. This is text too small. You can select and you can resize by using this properties tab. For text height, like I will set into 18 or 150. It is okay, 150. And we can move to the bottom a bit. Now we can copy this text object to here. That again in here. The next in this point. And the last at this point. Okay, sorry for this door, we can mirror the top, and I will delete this object and move from this point to here. Okay, that's it. And you can double click this text to edit, like I will set the name into erase. Here, set the name living room. Double click, we set into bedroom. Okay, in here we set into toilet. In here, dining room. And in the top, we set for bedroom. Okay, that's it. The last, we can insert for dimension. You can tap D to open dimension style manager, and I will use notative. You can click set current, click modify. So in here we use a default settings for notative, like for baseline spacing into this default option. For the color, I will set into red, and also in here this is for lines, and then for symbol arrows, change into architectural tick. For the text, I will change for text style. You can click in here for font name. We'll set into sec. It is a text. And click apply. Click close. Now for text color, set into sign. Like this. After it, you can click OK. Click this annotated text, and we don't forget to click set current. Close. Now for scale dimension, I will set into 150. You can change in it into 150 because we use notative scale. And the next, you can tap dim lin to create a dimension linear. Okay, but first I will unhide for center layer. Then create dimension start from this corner to a center in it. Click that again from this point to here. The next corner to center point. So it's very easy for you to set a dimension if you active for this center line, because it will be automatically snap into endpoint of this center line object. Okay, we click that in the top. Create again, then from this corner point into here. The next from this corner point to center point, and then from this point over here. Okay, the last in here. And then we can set from this counter point to this point. Okay. You can press F7 to hide guard. And then we already create this simple 2D floor plan with AutoCAD 2024. If you have any question about this tutorial, you can comment below this video.